Hey, how you doing?
We already know him.
Well, he's not on my DVD yet. Hey, come over here. We're doing an interview. You're going to be part of my deal. You're going to be on my YouTube.
He wants to play.
All right. First of all, we're going to ask the...
Excuse me.
Oh, no, he didn't. All right. We're going to have a basic question here. Gay, bi, straight, or confused? Okay.
Confused. You know that.
Okay. So, give us a little information. How did you like the parade this year?
It was fabulous.
Do you think it was better than last year's?
Yes.
It was it. Is there anything that you think they could have done differently?
Yes.
What could they have done differently?
Start it later.
Right. Okay. That's one of my main bitches. Like,
start it later and don't make the street think as long.
Exactly. Did you guys see any of the protesters or anything else like that, or any of the actions that happened with that? Did you? Okay.
Yeah.
What was your?
Like that?
Don't
bother me. Was kind of like okay with you?
Yeah.
And you were cool.
Everybody has different opinions.
There you go. I like that.
Right.
It didn't bother you that they were saying sort of things to you?
Nope.
And you handled it? You haven't, because you know who you are. We are gay.
There you go. Exactly.
We are strong.
We are strong.
Right.
We will survive. They will not.
And they're sad.
So that's true.
They have to do sad things for other people to make other people feel sad.
Feel bad, and that is not right.
This is cute.
I know. There we go. There's another one. And it is true.
What are you doing? I do not know.
Wait, no, he knows. My attitude. Yeah, he does. You know, it is my attitude.
I know you.
All right.
You don't do that.
Now say your name for my YouTube viewers.
Chuck.
Guess what, Lisa and I did.
What Tasha, did my poopa.
All right. I got you in the other deal.
Guess what, Lisa and I did?
What?
We have started the Daryl Jett Helping Hands Foundation, which is a 501c3. We will raise money to pay for the final expenses of those in the community so that nobody's final wishes are ever denied.
That's cool.
That's excellent. That's very good.
Now, how did that go about?
My name's Kim.
Kim, I'm Janice.
Nice to meet you, Janice. Knows me.
Well, I don't know him though.
He goes to our church. He's a member of our church.
Everybody knows.
Sorry.
Me.
Do you know how to delete things? Don't.
Yes,
you?
Yes, I will edit that out.
I did a few minutes too. 110%
of the money that we raise will go to the foundation. I do glass cutting. I cut beer bottles and wine bottles. I turn them into juice glasses and tea glasses. And
I want to know you.
Say your name. Or say your phone number. So I'll remember that.
Phone number.
She's like, no, I'm not gonna do that.
We will be here next year.
Next year.
And 100% of the profit. And I told Lisa, I was like, oh my God, how awesome is this? We get to drink the alcohol and then we sell ourselves the trash.
Excellent.
Hey, recycled art.
Excellent.
Recycled art.
And then we're going to have a mobile drag room.
What is that?
We're going to get
a
motor home.
Uh-huh.
Turn it into a drag room. You can rent it for the night. You have
a
designated driver.
Okay.
You have privacy so that nobody knows what you've got going on in your show.
Okay.
And then you have the security of knowing that nobody's going to step on your crown. Thank you, Empress Paige. So you can rent that, and 100% of that goes into the foundation. And we will pay for the final expenses for those in the community.
I am very nice to know you.
That way, when someone says, I want to be buried beside my brother, and then we have a show to raise money to make sure they get buried. And before the show even starts, he ends up having him cremated by the county for free. That will never happen again. And Daryl Jett is the face of our foundation.
Now, when you say final deals, now what happens if family members step in? Because family members supposedly go over.
No. We're going to do. I got to get out of the sun.
Okay.
What we're going to do beforehand is when someone like Daryl knew for about a month and a half before his passing, he knew what was going to happen.
Right.
At that time, we will get with that person and we will do a power of attorney.
Okay.
As well as a designation of final remains.
Yeah.
And that way, if you and I are together and I'm like, oh, I want to be buried and I want to be this and I want to be that, there's already with, and I work for an attorney, so that kind of helps out, but there's already somebody that can go, yeah, you're not going to pocket this money because this is what they said they wanted. And our foundation will be 110% respecting the wishes of those that are passing.
Give a card?
No.
Well, I'm going to say this. With that little bit in mind, keep me in mind, since I do videography, this is a good deal to get these people on video for their last wishes.
It's going
to
be, it's going to be huge.
That's very true.
It's going to be very, very huge.
It is true.
My wife.
Which is?
Somewhere around there.
She's over there somewhere.
Okay.
Daryl was her brother, and his wishes were not respected.
Right, and I hate that.
In any way, shape, or fashion. And after that, I decided that I am going to do whatever it is that I have to do. I do glass work. I take beer bottles, champagne bottles, wine bottles, and I turn them into tea glasses and wine glasses. And I have a woman who, if we are a 501c3, she wants to donate 5 burial pots to the foundation. Five burial pots is... That's huge. I've never in my life had to buy a burial plot. I'm assuming they're expensive. Well, I don't know.
They are.
But as soon as we get 501c3, she wants to donate 5 burial plots to the foundation. She said, we're all older. We're never going to use them. All of us want to be cremated. If it can go to a good cause, it goes to a good cause. So next year, Gay Pride, you're going to see us, and hopefully...
Okay.
God willing, and the creek doesn't rise, I'll have my baby out here next year.
Excellent.
Oh, congratulations.
You got a baby? Are you pregnant?
No, I'm not yet.
But not yet. Okay.
We're hoping to start this month. So a year later, we should be ready to go. But next year, we will have our glasses out here. We've got juice glasses, champagne glasses, tea glasses, wind chimes, lamps, the works made out of beer bottles.
Wow.
Which is the shit.
Recycled.
I mean, literally.
Yeah,
I get to drink the alcohol and sell y'all my trash.
Now, make sure you don't drink enough to where you're going to be able to work.
No, I mean, really.
That is very good.
I get to drink the liquor, y'all buy my trash.
There you go.
There is nothing better. It's the truth.
It's true.
So, next year, look for us. We're the Daryl Jed Helping Hands Foundation. And everything that you buy from us, you will get a receipt that is tax write-offable.
Good, good.
Which I think is huge.
Right.
You know, whether you make a $5 donation or you make a $100 donation, it is all tax write-offable. So come find us next year, and we're going to have some amazing shit for you.
Excellent.
Great.
Because I got an entire year to keep cutting
there
glass bottles.
But,
you know, the more I screw up, the more I have to drink.
Now, why are you screwing up? Because you're drinking? Or?
No. I screw up so I can drink.
Ah, interesting. Okay. You have a good day.